Thank you. Welcome, everyone. Welcome to Mike Webster Stadium on the beautiful Rhinelander High School campus. It is a perfect fall night for soccer. Tonight, the regional semifinals between the Ashland Oerdockers and the Rhinelander Hodags. Before we get to the starting lineups, please join me in standing, face the flag, remove your hats for our country's national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched.
Your starting lineups tonight for the Ashland Orr-Dockers. Senior number 00, Owen Britton. Sophomore number 2, Randy Goyke. Senior number 7, Marshall Swanson. Senior number 10, Xavier Adams. Junior number 12, Rainey Sims. Junior number 14, Peter Fonchi. Senior number 16, Louis Fishbach. Senior number 19, Ethan Guski. Senior number 20, Austin Biscochil. Junior number 24, David Goyke. And senior number 26, Matthew Nortonen. Head coach, Stan Schrock. Good luck, Orr-Dockers. And for your Rhinelander Hodags, senior number 1, Cooper Recky. Senior number 3, Braden Moore. Senior number 4, Kyle Weiss. Senior number 6, Andrew Hendricks. Senior number 7, Shane Petrick. Junior number 11, Will Quinn. Senior number 18, Leo Loesch. Junior number 23, Neil Weigel. Senior number 24, Charlie Heck. Junior number 25, Mason Shinners. And junior number 30, Matthew King. Head coach, Nathan Bates. Good luck, gentlemen. And it's a great night for soccer. Let's go!
There you have it, our starting 11s for tonight. As the Hodags get set to take on the Ashland Orr-Dockers, Rhinelander, a team that scored 3.4 goals per game this season, allowed less than one goal per contest, mainly part of the strong senior back line for the Hodags, including senior netminder Cooper Radke. 0.88 goals against average and save percentage near 82 of the season. Hodags wear the black uniforms that Ashland in the all whites. Jerome Jones, the man in the middle, wearing the red tonight, flanked on the outsides. Benny Gutierrez. Set up the attack, they work it to their back line. Swanson on the far flank. Tries to go up line. Ashland will try to push the edge. That's cleared by Kyle Weiss, far side. Hodags Mork trying to get a man on the run. That shitter's on the far flank. One on three, tries to send it back. It's deflected toward the corner. Shenners will track it down, let it go out of bounds. And moments into the match, we have our first quarter kick of the night. Andrew Henricks, the senior to take it. Header by Charlie Hack, just up over the bar. Good look for the Hodags. Sails just over the bar. And keeper Owen Britton. Ashland on the goal kick. Possessed by the Hodags. Shenners looks to settle. Far flank for Shane Petrick. Leading scorer for the Hodags. Tries to slice one in on a cross. It's well wide. Petrick with 15 goals this season. Most of them coming in non-conference action. Heck scored 5 earlier this year in a game against Hayward. Another goal kick for the Ordockers. Played again by the Hodags, sent forward looking for Shenners. A group of white jerseys convenes, now possessed by Ashland. Swanson looking for something, has it dispossessed by Mork on the far side. Sent off in the touch, last off of Ashland. No, they reversed the call, Ordockers throw. Put in play on the far side. Looked like Rennie Sims to put it in play. Ball deflected it back out in the touch, another Ashland throw toward the middle of the field, and a little space to work with that time for Lewis Fishbach, but take it away. Here comes Petrick in the counterattack. Far flank, top of the 18, has numbers. Petrick just up over the bar. Bullet looks, seeking the upper right 90. Sails high. Another goal kick for the Ordockers. Captain's Austin Descosel to take it. Knocked away the midfield by Quinn for a moment, but now possessed by Ashland. Ordockers near side. Goyke has it taken away by Petrick near side. Looks to send one up the middle, has Mork. Mork top of the 18, and he misses just high. Tracers from the Hodags, some dangerous looks in the opening minutes. Nothing yet on frame, as we're 0-0 in the fourth minute. Rhinelander are already with some very quality attacks. Headed by Mork off the goal kick. Near side, Charlie Heck with space. Carries it along, now chips it forward. He's looking near side for Shenners, bounds free. Ashland plays ahead. Adams. Works far flank, cut under and intercepted by Matthew King. Now played up line by Ashland. Goyke far side. Contact from behind, and Manny Gutierrez put the flag up the far side. The AR calling the foul there on the Hodags. First free kick of the night, it goes to the Ordockers from 50 yards. It's Ward Radke, but headed away by the defense. Weiss in space, sends one long far side for Mork. Has numbers with Shenners if he hurries. Ashland retreating back. We'll be able to defuse that. And midfield played by King. Near side, Quinn looking to set things up, switching to the near side for Heck. Heck with some space. Looks up for Quinn, tried to give and go to Shenners up the middle, was denied. Ball deflects off an Ashland shoe near side, but played. That is Ethan Guskey who had it. Petrick, near side, a little cheeky move along the touchline, then puts it off of Guskey. It will be a Hodag throw. Throw in deflected by Shenners, chipped ahead by Mork, looking to cross it far side. Hodag's trying to get over there with Henricks, ball deflects, and Henricks will earn a corner. Putting that one off for Sims. second quarter of the match for the Hodags. And it will again be Hendricks to take it. Charlie Heck nodded one last time high, the Hodags' first corner attempt. On the same side. Top of the six, headed by Heck, it's loose. Cleared off the back line by the Ashland defense. Sent back in, and this time saved by Britton. Sims cleared it off the back line off the initial volley by Heck. Keeping this a 0-0 game. Rhinelander will track at its own end. Heck near side looking for Pete Trick. Lost it between his heels out of bounds. Throw in Ashland. David Goyke on the throw, near side. Back to Goyke up line. Wide the intended mark looking for Guski. Hodags possess. Petrick tips it along. For Quinn. Had the Leo Loesch, lost the handle. Now picked up by Marshall Swanson. Back to midfield, Ashland collects. Fishbach, far side, looking for a cross, too strong. Swanson couldn't track that down, throw it to the Hodags. Rhinelander tries to send one up line. Hendricks deflected it back into the midfield. Still loose on that far flank. Now Weiss has it. Sends one high, rainbowing one. Schenner splits the defense in the box. Open look, wide right. Schenner's had timed it well and split the defense. But the Hodags, the story of the first 7 minutes plus. Good looks, not much on frame. Six shots, one on goal so far. Another old Docker goal kick. Rhinelander wins it. Hendricks ahead. Mork from 35. Near side for Petrick. Petrick cuts back to the middle of the field. Chipped ahead for Schenner's, knocked away. Petrick wins it back. A foot race on the near side. Has help from Loesch from behind. Will distribute back to Charlie Heck. Loesch with space in the middle. Ahead for Quinn. Couldn't field it cleanly. Fishbach. As Ashland tries to mount a counterattack. It's defused by Weiss and sent well in the touch. And adjacent to Hodag student section that's here tonight. Off the throw near side. Fishbach. In space as Swanson. Far side. It's knocked away by the Hodag defense. Still loose far side. Gained by Hendricks. Deflected off an Ashland player out there. Throw in Rhinelander was off of Fanky, number 14. Peter Fanky, a junior. Really quick deflection and a touch. Another Hodag throw. Weiss. Far side. Will carry. Now trying to slot one to Hendricks. It was knocked away on a soft touch. Ashland trying to counterattack. Ramdy Gookie on the far side. Has speed around Loesch. Into the box. Has a crosser. Instead takes it himself. And it's covered up by Ratke. Had Xavier Adams crossing from behind middle of the field. Did Goyke, but instead took it himself. And Ashland's first shot on goal of the match. Matthew King now in space for the Hodags. Up line, far side, Hendricks can't hold on. Throw it Ashland. Far side, Hendricks trying to win it along the far line. Still fought for over there. Chipped long by Ashland and into touch. Throw in Hodags. Loesch, a short throw to King near the half line. Still fought for on the far side. King trying to get it away from Fanky over the far side. Instead sends it out of bounds. Nearing the 10-minute mark, 0-0 game. Hodags the better of it so far. Six shots to one in this match. But both teams with one shot on frame. Charlie Heck, the Hodag back line, distributes near side for Petrick. Gets around his man. Trying to work back around to the near side against David Gookie. Blakey has it near side, ahead for Adams. Sent high. Petrick juggling off his chest, lobs one ahead, looking for Shinners. First two was Ashland, steered in the touch by the Oerdockers. Throwing at Rhinelander. Norton and sent that away. Petrick on the throw. Deflected by Mort. Loesch, a quick look. It's bobbled and deflected. It will be covered inbounds by Britton. Bullet of a shot from long range by Leo Loesch. Owen Britton, the senior, up to the task. His second save of the match. Petrick looking to win space on the near side. He'll explore from long range. Britton there, just outside the six. Majority of the match has been played in the Oerdockers' end so far. Still nil-nil here, the first quarter hour. Shitters between two defenders. Still has it. Back to Petrick. Can't get a foot on it. Mork is there. Back to Petrick. Mork can't find space as Ashland congests the middle of the box and clears. Oerdockers a chance on a counterattack. Had a man potentially offside, but the flag didn't go up. They play on. Randy Gutke looked to be ahead for a second, but Ashland don't make anything of it. Weiss on the far side. Henricks ahead for Mork. Looked to flip one back to Henricks on a give and go. Couldn't catch it cleanly off the back of the heel. Sent out of bounds by the Oerdockers, throwing Rhinelander. Header by Mork. That one will likely roll across the byline. Goal kick, Ashland. Nil-nil in the 13th minute. Another Oerdocker goal kick coming up here. Henricks couldn't field it cleanly on the far side. That will be an Oerdocker throw. King up line, but wide. Oerdockers will throw it again in front of their own bench. Put in play along the near side, tipped along by Swanson. And out of bounds, throw in to the Hodangs. King at the half line. Looking for Mork. Bicycle kick high into the air. Shinners sends it back. Heck, with some space. One coming from behind. Contact they play on. Couldn't get it ahead to Petrick. Dispossessed by David Goyke. Up the near side, Neil Weigel able to clear it for the Hodangs. Mork, back of the head, looking for Shinners just outside the box. Bounce free to Henricks. He'll rainbow one high and wide to the right. And we'll get a Hodag sub for the first time tonight. Will Gretzinger, the junior, checking in. And we'll replace Henricks at that outside midfield position. Gretzinger with 3 goals on the season. Weigel couldn't hold it off the goal kick. Now the Hodags possess. Weiss near the half line, looking across near side for Petrick. That one canceled out by the Oerdockers and Vitasco. Petrick now 50 yards away. Crossing for, he had Gretzinger. Mork cut it off. Don't think Mork saw Gretzinger crossing on the opposite flank. Fought for in the midfield. Now gained by Gretzinger, far side. Mork working back for Gretzinger on a give and go. Tips back to Mork, sent to the middle for Shinners. Shinners taken down. They play on. Weigel in space. Quinn looking for Petrick, steered away. And sent in the touch by the Oerdockers. Quarter minute, hour gone by, still no score. The Hodags have had much the better of the look so far. Ramdy Goyke sending it in the touch. Get a throw in for Ash for Rhinelander, excuse me. Weiss couldn't handle that cleanly. Dispossessed by Goyke, far side. Trying to tip one back to Fenke there. Hodags will repossess it in midfield. Quinn has Petrick up line, instead will carry it the middle. Slots to Mork, give and go. Quinn, top of the 18, will Quinn! Save made by Britton, it's still free, and now cleared out by Ashland. Owen Britton has already come up big for the Oradockers in the first 15 minutes plus of this match. That was his fourth save. Quinn trying to gather in from 35. Knocks it forward. In traffic, far side, chipped by Mork, looking for Schinner's knocked away, rather he's going for Petrick. Gained back in by the Hodags. Here's Gretzinger ahead. Mork, top of the 18, tips it on. Petrick, near side of the box. Back to the goal, can't get one on. It's steered away by the Oradockers. Sent to the touch by David Goyke. Throw in Rhinelander. Oradockers have one on at the flag, looking to sub in. Unable to do so as of yet. Mork tried to flick one into the box, cleared. Goyke near side. Gathered back by Petrick on a cross. Deflected out. Weiss traps it and plays it. Sends it back far side for King. Back in the midfield. Hodags redistribute, looking near side. Cut off. That was intended for Petrick on the near side. Played by David Goyke. Now they try to send Ramdi Goyke on a run midfield. Tipped along by Adams, but cleared. Jostling there between Goyke and Matthew King on a foul on the Hodags. Similar spot as the first foul is free kick from 50. Sent high into the box, off the chest of an Ashland man, and picked out of the air by Cooper Retke. Adams with the deflection. Fishback was coming in for the header, and Retke snatched it out of the air. Schinner's ahead to Mork, back to Schinner's 40 yards away. Petrick as Ashland really congesting the middle, forcing the Hodags to attack the flanks right now. King has Quinn, 30 yards, tries to force one between two defenders. Dispossessed by the Oradockers. Guski ahead, this is Ramdi Goyke. Crossed near side, Guski lost the handle. Petrick near side has a chance to carry up line. Cross to the top of the 18. It's loose there. Schenner's got a piece. Hodags can't get a clean foot on it. Gretzinger now looking to reset. Back to Weiss. Weiss with space, 40 yards, trying to chip one back in the middle. Take it away, Gretzinger a look, rolls one, diving save, rebound for Schinners, it's saved, not a chance for a third effort. Mork couldn't quite get the redirect, two great saves by Owen Britton, keep us scoreless. Now we get a whistle. And the Hodags were offside. Free kick for the Oradockers, 20 yards from their own net. Loesch possesses near the half line looking for Gretzinger. That one knocked in the touch by Ashland. Both teams looking to sub. Henricks will return for Rhinelander. That's William Dykstra, Jr. in for Ashland, number four. Mork taps it back far side. King looking for the deep cross to Petrick. Ashland will play it. Goyke near side. Looking to carry up line. Actually check that's Henricks on the near flank now for the Hodags. It's Petrick getting a breather. Adams taken away by Heck. Poked free by Quinn at the half line. Has numbers. Couldn't quite send it along. Shenners was waiting the timer on up the middle. Quinn to Mork, near side. Henricks back in the middle for Quinn. Lost the handle. Now poked back to the top of the 18. Tipped in by Shenners. Right to Britton, who will cover before anything comes of that. 21st minute, 0-0. Opening stanza controlled by the Hodags so far. Shots 12-1 in favor of Rhinelander. Six saves thus far. For Ashland keeper Owen Britton, keeping this level. Mordockers with the throw on the far side. Swanson to put it in. Throw one into the box. Ashland a chance. Block comes free. Deflects. Goal kick. There's been one spot at times. Rhinelander has struggled defensively this year. It's been guarding set pieces in the attacking third. Free kicks, corner kicks. That throw was essentially an extended corner into the box. Rhinelander able to defuse that situation. And now trying to look to rebuild the attack. Weiss cross far side for Gretzinger. That one will just barely roll out. And Gutierrez is a long way away. But with a look clear down line, put up the flag. As that one rolled out. Throwing for the Ordockers, deep in their defensive third. Headed along. Now played by Rhinelander. Quinn back to King. Far side. Quinn ahead of his mark. And that one poked into touch by Dykstra for Ashland. Hodags try to force it up the middle. It's cleared. Now gained by Rhinelander a little bit of space. Charlie Heck, 35 yards away, has one. Charlie Heck! 1-0 the Hodags with a long distance response. Heck, the senior defender, with only his second goal of the year, and it comes at a great time. 1-0 the Hodags in the 23rd minute.
First score of the game for the Hodags. Senior number 24, Charlie Heck.
Rhinelander on the board. 1-0 Rhinelander. Will double check at half the assist on that one. It came back off the half. And Heck was able to dribble up to about 35 yards and let one fly. And found the upper left 90. Ashland looking to answer far side. They have not had much in terms of offense so far. But sent an exploratory effort for the far flank there. That sailed high and wide right. Swanson with the look. And a goal kick for the Hodags. Short goal kick. King will bring it up the far flank for Weiss. Kyle Weiss, the senior, directing traffic. Couldn't keep that one in. And a throw to the Ordockers at the fringes of the attacking third. 25th minute, 1-0 the Hodags on Charlie Heck's long-range strike at 22:56. Ashland keeper Owen Britton has gotten a lot in this first half, but Heck was able to place one. Britton couldn't get a mitt on it. Hodags send that one quickly back out of bounds. Ordocker throw. Roughly 40 yards away. Dykstra will pump once. He'll come near side. Fishbach plays it for Ashland, looks to send it ahead, and a man coming in, cleared out of there by Ratke. And a whistle and a handball foul on the Oerdackers near the half line. Looked like they were trying to find Adams on that through ball. Not before the Hodag counterattack, and now Kyle Weiss. We scored a couple on direct kicks this year. But we'll play this one short to Matthew King. Give it go back to Weiss. We'll chip one toward the top of the 18, looking for Bork. Steered wide by the Oerdackers. Dykstra will keep it in, far touchline. Oerdackers will send it up far side to midfield. Ball headed away, Heck will gather it in. And off of the center back has the game's lone goal, but that's where we are right now. Truth be told, Heck's had a couple of the best looks in this match so far. He also gets in there on the corners and has had a couple of well-placed nods that have been denied. Ashland throw near side. They look towards Adams at the top of the 18, and it's cleared. Quinn has space. 3-on-4 into the attack, looking to send one for Petrick. One man back deep, sweeping that away was Viscosel. Hodags regain. Retzinger looking for the corner, but nobody making a run. Ashland able to send that one upline. Hodags, King with space. Plays it for Mork. Mork with the cross. Has a man in there looking for Quinn. It hesitated. Now Henrik's a look. Denied. Corner kick, Rhinelander. Our third corner of the match coming up. Henrik's again to take it. Charlie Heck pushes up to the back post for Heck. Nearly had his second. That one goes just wide. Goal kick, Oerdackers. Charlie Heck has had some very dangerous looks off the corner so far tonight. Nothing's gone home, but it hasn't been for a lack of trying. Legs up. 1-0 here in the 28th minute, looking to add to it. Mork, far side. Sent high in the air by the Oerdackers. Petrick looking to split defenders. Over to the far side, Mork crossing it. Henrik's there. Britton got there first. Takes a little contact in the interim, but boots it away. Ashland now, a chance to send one up the middle, looking for Amdi Goki. It was steered aside. Ashland was looking to push against the pretty flat back four. Both teams now subbing. Leo Loesch returning for the Hodags. He takes out Kyle Weiss. It looks like Milo Gomez, a freshman, number 9, in for the Oerdackers. Ball headed near side. Ashland will let that roll out, knowing the throw-in is theirs anyway. Put in play by Swanson. Top of the 18. Ball chips free. Headed into the box. Now cleared. Quinn. Ball bounds, edge of the 18, Shenners as Gretzinger, but Ashland. It's most sustained pressure in the attacking third so far tonight. Contact and a foul. Gomez clipping heels, and now we'll get a stoppage as there's a Hodag shaken up, and I believe that is Garrett Yonker in the middle. It is. Ian Gomez clicking heels. Yonker down, and a stoppage here in the 30th minute. Take a knee as the training staff goes out to check on Garrett Yonker, junior midfielder, and now both teams will head back toward their respective sidelines. like the heels got crossed up between the two. Ashland was called with a trip. It'll be a free kick for Rhinelander when we resume play. 30th minute, 1-0. The Hodags in front again. Winner moves on to the regional final game. Should the Hodags win, it would be here. Keeping an eye on the Lakeland-New London game. And the T-Birds are a few minutes away from finishing that one off. They lead 5-0 in the 75th minute. Lakeland, the 3-seed, going up against the 6th-seeded Bulldogs in that match. Lakeland led 5-0 at the half, and that gap has stayed. Yonker needing assistance to the Hodag bench. And we'll take a seat on the training table behind the bench as he continues to get evaluated after what appeared to be a lower body injury. Free kick on the restart. Heck shimmies near side, looking for Gretzinger, cleared away. Comes right back to Charlie Heck. Ooh. And we'll get a stoppage. I believe that was Gomez who just got drilled by that Charlie Heck clearance. And he'll need a minute to recompose himself. Singer came in on the stoppage. They had to stop the clock for the Gomez injury, so he must come off. Looks like Gusky back there to take his place. A drop ball as we return to play. Loesch near side for Gretzinger. Advantage Ashland as Gretzinger had a little bit of a push there, but they play on. Heck near side off the heels of Adams and in the touch. Rhinelander throw. You're looking closely. You saw Jerome Jones go to the whistle. He didn't clearly signal advantage, but you certainly could tell that's what was going on there. Ashland had the attack at that moment. Even if a foul has been committed, if a team that was fouled has the clear federal play at the moment, they'll let the action
10 continue. Minutes remaining.
So we've hit the half hour mark here at Mike Webster Stadium. 1-0 the Hodags on Charlie Heck, 23rd minute goal. Rhinelander near side, Shinners. Across far side for Petrick, tipped back, now gathered by Mork, sent ahead for Gretzinger, and cleared by Ashland. Back to the midfield, Weigel near side. Rainbows one near flank. Edge of the 18 for Shinners. Ashland will win the race for it. Now Shinners fights back. And he and Gretzinger in a congested position. And Shinners just had to kick that one away. Gwynn now gathers in for the Hodags, looking far for more, cleared away. Ashland sends it far side into touch. Whistle and a Hodag substitution now. Looks like it'll be Henricks returning to the match. He'll grab Will Gretzinger. And a throw to Rhinelander. Played far side, Mork looking across. Shinners, backdoor, Henricks. The Shinners, ball's free! And rolls in the touch, corner kick. It may have been Britton who shielded that ball, who was last to touch it. The Ashland keeper. Henricks, near side. Back door. Britton got a hand on it before Heck could get the noggin on. Ball taken away, near side, Leo Loesch. Looking. looking to the corner, but nobody there. Played by Fanke near side and sent out of bounds. Along the near side, Henricks. Looking for help. Marked tightly on the near side, now dispossessed. That's Fanke on the near side, sends it back to Goyke up line. Has his man there in Adams, taken away by Leo Loesch. Loesch will send it ahead. Schenner's on to Mork, looks to slip it through to Petrick, couldn't quite get it behind the defense. Ashland far side will send it up the middle. Weiss will hook one out of bounds. As we near 7 minutes to play in the opening stanza. Swanson working with Dykstra far side, now back to the middle. Sent along by Weigel ahead. Schenner's now will send it back. Weigel up line for Petrick. Meet out by David Goyke. Rowan Rhinelander to the middle of the field looking for Quinn. He'll defer to Leo Loesch, now between two defenders. Back to Loesch, in space. He'll look from 35. This one goes well wide left. About the range from which Charlie Heck scored for the Hodags in the 23rd minute. That's our lone goal so far. Subs for Ashland. Ramdi Goyke has returned. Immediately touches off the goal kick. Lost possession, Loesch over to Matthew King on the far side. There's 6 minutes to go in the opening half. Ashland trying to build an attack. Nearly had a man on the back side there with Guskey. Weigel able to defuse that. Now Petrick sends ahead. Has more. Can he get there? Top of the 18. Schenner's in position. Mason Schenner's shot is blocked. Reloads. Cross for Petrick. He'll settle. One touch. Fired right into the face of David Goyke in a corner for the Hodags. Fifth quarter kick of the match for Rhinelander. And they will stop clock. Again, it was David Goyke who caught the worst of that kick by Petrick. But may have sacrificed something to prevent a goal there. That was a hard kick ball from a dangerous position. Corner kick, back door Heck. Trying to deflect it to Petrick, still loose. Now gathered by Ashland and cleared. Sent out by Fanke. Less than five to go in the opening half. Hodags again trying to build the attack off the left flank. Mork, edge of the 18. Has one, goal! Braden Mork! A bullet from 20 to the upper right 90, and it's 2-0 Rhinelander. Braden Mork, his 14th goal of the season. And the Hodags up 2-0 in the 36th minute.
Second score of the night for the Hodags. Senior number 3, Braden Mork.
We saw it from the onset. Rhinelander hard shot seeking the corners. They missed a couple of very good looks in the opening minutes. Their two tallies have been struck with pace to the upper corners. Lead 2-0 here late first half. Ashland try to mount something here before the break. Charlie Heck will just steer that into the touch, and Ashland will have an attacking third throw in. Put in play by Swanson. comes free, edge of the 18. King first two. Weiss looking to shield. Ashland a sliding attempt. A save made by Ratke. That was the Castle pushing up into the attack with that look. Just the second shot on frame for the Oradockers tonight. 3.5 minutes to go in the opening half. Weigel ahead, Shitters behind the defense, Mason Shitters. It's 3-0 Rhinelander. That ball floated in the air. And Shitters waited, timed the run, got past the defense and finished. Two goals in a matter of a minute, 21 seconds for the Hodags. It's Shinners from Neil Weigel, and Rhinelander up 3-0.
Third Horaid goal of the night. Assist Neil Weigel. Over to Mason Shinners, number 25.
For the pressure that we've seen in this opening half. Hodags a couple of goals late before halftime. And maybe not done. Here comes Petrick up the far flank. Gathers and looks to cross between defenders. Henricks ahead for more. Cleared aside. Make that Quinn who sent it in. Just barely knew. Weigel tried to keep it in near side. It just rolled out of bounds. The throw in, it belongs to Rhinelander. Weigel towards Shinners at the corner of the 18. It was head of the way. Played for a moment by Quinn off the side of Ashland foot. Kept in for a moment. Rolled out of bounds by Adams. Petra couldn't handle that. Weigel throw goes out. Throw in Ashland and the substitution in. David Goyke, who had caught that ball to the face a couple of minutes ago, blocking a Shane Petrick effort. He returns. Petrick with the header off the throw-in. Ball comes free near side, possessed by the Oradockers. Here's Adams, dispossessed by Henricks. Finds Bork in space, backdoor cross. Gretzinger has one. Wide. Check that rather. Appeared to be Henricks on the attempt on the far side. Less than 100 seconds remain in the opening half. Rhinelander leading 3-0 and trying to add to it. Charlie Heck will look to redistribute from midfield. Nearly got beaten to the ball there by Guski. A lot of contact and now a push on the Oradockers. Free kick Rhinelander. Heck sends it quickly. Was looking for Mork, but he came off it. Ashland first two, and you're a minute to play. Hodags will send that one into touch.
1 minute to go.
Ball bounding free. Ashland looking to set something up. The Castle. Hodags gather in. Far flank, Mork is open. Drops it back for Henricks. 35 seconds before the break. King pushing up, has it far flank for the Hodags. Trying to work it up line. 25 seconds. Henricks. Far corner, nobody there. Ashland will just send that one deep into touch with 15 seconds left and a half. Hodags will try to throw in quickly.
Mark
will put it in play
nine.
With 10.
Eight,
back it goes.
Seven,
Will Quinn.
Six.
Quinn marked tightly.
Four,
back to King.
Three,
King tried
two,
to have a desperation
one.
Look. It's chipped into the box. Hodags can do nothing with it before halftime, but a couple of late scores have the Hodags in command here, leading the Oradockers 3-0 at the half.
And at halftime, the Hodags lead 3-0.
And recapping the scoring, Charlie Heck for the Hodags in the 23rd minute. Braden Mork of the 36th minute and Mason Shinners of the 37th minute for Rhinelander. Our unofficial stats Rhinelander out shooting Ashland at 22-4 in the first half, and a 9-2 edge in shots on goal. Fouls pretty even. Hodag's goal with two fouls and an offsides. Ashland three fouls. Five corner kicks so far for the Hodags. Ashland has yet to take a corner. Halftime here at Mike Webster. 3-0. Rhinelander leads. And we can confirm that the winner of this game will get third seeded Lakeland in the regional finals on Saturday night. The T-Birds defeating New London 5-0 tonight. So that's where we stand at halftime. We'll step aside. Back with the second half. In a few moments, it's Rhinelander Schools production, WIA Division 3, boys playoff soccer. Thank you. A couple of minutes away from the second half here in Rhinelander. The Hodags leading the Ashland Orthodoxers by a count of 3-0. Updating some of the scoring for the first half, going back and watching the footage, which you can as well. And you're hearing me right now, you are on the Rhinelander Schools YouTube channel. Will Gretzinger had the assist on that Charlie Heck goal in the 23rd minute. It was Andrew Henricks on the assist to the Raiden Mort goal in the 36th minute. And again, Neil Weigel had the assist on Mason Schenner's tally in the 37th.
No, you asked me it the other day.
Again, as we said, winner of this match will get third-seeded Lakeland on Saturday. Be right here at Mike Webster Stadium should this result hold. T-Birds 5-0 victors over New London, a game that went final a short while ago up in Managua. Medford is the top seed in this bracket, and they are in control over Antigo, leading 7-0 at the half. That's a 1-versus-8 matchup. Mosinee, the other GNC school in this field, and they are at fourth seeded Wapaka tonight. Have not seen an update of that one come in as of yet. Medford, the GNC champs, though they were upended by Northland Pines at the end of the regular season. Though that Pine side is, they proved tonight with an upset over Three Lakes to start the WIA Division IV tournament. Rodney Sternhagen, a former Hodag assistant. The man in charge up in Eagle River, and he's got those Eagles playing hard here at tournament time. About ready to begin the second half here. The Hodags 40 minutes away from punching a ticket to the regional finals.
All right, we're ready to start the second half. Let's hear some
heading north to be in half number two. Again, Rhinelander in black, Jenners, who had the third goal for Rhineland, will put this one in play. As we begin half number two, Charlie Heck, quick send up the middle. It's knocked away. Shinners gains it back. Has a flick to Braden Morg. Morg across. Oh, and Britton diving for effect, but that one going well wide. Goal kick, the Ordockers. Everybody getting a little chuckle out of that. A bit of a pantomime, perhaps, by the Ashland keep. Contact off the goal kick and a foul called against Ashland there. Fishbach with a contact against Petrick. Free kick, Rhinelander. They play it quickly. Heck, far side, give and go. Charlie Heck, top of the 18. A lot of traffic, sends it back to Petrick. Was looking for Mork in the midfield and it's cleared away. Back to center. Matthew King near side. Looking ahead for Mork. It's deflected and sent forward touch. Should, throw they say belongs to the Ordockers. Ashland throw on the near side. Swanson. Played up line. Has Adams. In the middle, looking to send across on the deep flank. This is Gusky. Can't get there. That one rolls in the touch. Rowan Rhinelander, early stages, second half. Hodags in command, 3-0. Along the far side, they do rule that one out of bounds. Rowan Rhinelander. Petrick puts it in play. Ashland will send it back in the middle. King, able to jar it ahead, looking for Mork, who couldn't quite redirect. Comes to the near side and sent long by the Ordockers. Headed by Swanson, far side, steered away by Rhinelander. Weigel over on that far end. Sent in the touch by Ashland, throw in the Hodags. Rhinelander puts it in play, far side, Schinner's edge of the 18. Petrick will have a look, crossing for the back side. Couldn't quite connect with Andrew Henricks, crashing in for the back flank. Throwing Ashland. Played up line to the Ordockers, tipped along. Looking for Ramdi Gokey. Hodag backline has it. Charlie Heck looking for Petrick. Was well wide, and this one sent an exploratory effort from half. Played calmly by Radke. That one was going wide of goal anyway. Be able to hear it clear across the field. Head coach Nathan Bates giving instruction to his midfielders. Rhinelander trying to cross one in. Petrick for the far flank. Britton there ahead of Braden Morg. Pick it up and boot it away. Handball. That one bounced up and caught Kyle Weiss on an awkward hop. Free kick Ordockers. Strong boot on the near side into the box, put in by Fishbach. Comes back out, Hodags in space. Quinn looking to slot one to Mork, who got crossed up, was expecting that in. Quinn taps right hand to heart. The universal signal of my bad. As those two couldn't quite find the connection that time. Mork. Looked to cross it in the Shinners. It was knocked free. Ashland trying to counter ahead to Goki. It's cleared away by Charlie Heck. Throwing for the Oardockers in the attacking third. Ashland with five shots so far in this match, two of which have been on frame. Oldags have had the better of play so far tonight. 23 shots with nine on frame. Throw in, Swanson into the box, headed by Hodags and headed by Ashland near the top of the 18 and cleared out. Fishbach sends it to his back line. Weiss sends it ahead for the Hodags, looking to find Petrick far side. Looking to slot one for Shinners. It's steered wide by David Goyke. In the touch throw on Rhinelander, Petrick goes quickly. Missed Mork, but has him out of the backside. A one-hopper straight into the chest of Owen Britton. That shot taken by Henricks. First shot on goal for the Hodags this half. Comes in the 46th minute. Petrick will send it along. Ball comes free. Strong challenge by Hex. Sends it ahead. Petrick on the far side. Crosses back. Contact and jostling going on there. Quinn, they played on. Now they got the push on Ashland. Free kick for the Hodags, and Charlie Heck has scored from near this distance already. This one, he'll chip to the top of the 18. Redirected by Bork right on frame. And a one-hopper save by Owen Britton. Britton boots it away. That after making his eighth save of the match. Eggs will try to gain possession along the far line there. Played in the touch by Weigel, throw in Ashland. Throw played in the midfield by the Oardockers. Trying to send one here high, just missing the outside post. A long range look by Lewis Fishbach. Results in a Rhinelander goal kick. Hodags will play it short and distribute with their back line. Petrick ahead, has Heck, a little space. Petrick, up line right. Look to send it deep, it's steered away by the Oardockers. Out of bounds, and Rhinelander will have a throw. Eggs had a quick sub. Now we are back in play. Heck. Try to chip one in near side. Henricks on the back side. Possesses ahead to Mork. Mork crossing back looking for Henricks. Lost the foot race there. Fishbach first two, but kept in, but no. Mork could not keep it in. It's a throw in to the Oardockers. Ball free at midfield. Ramdy Goki near his side, cut off by King. Picked up by Loesch, looks to lightly tap one ahead, but Goki there. It runs straight into two marks. King, stinned to the left arm, but they play on. Ashland certainly wanted the foul, and if I'm being frank, they may have had a case. Either way, goes straight to Britton, who will send one along. Mork, 30-yard attempt, wide. A goal kick for the Oardockers. Taken by Norton. Hodags first to Petrick. Hodags will look to reset with their back line. Far side it goes. Petrick in the touch. Couldn't track that one down. Throw at Ashland. As we near a half hour to go in regulation, the Hodags leading 3-0. very strong position to advance to Saturday night's regional finals, which would be here at Mike Webster Stadium should this result hold, against the Lakeland T-Birds. Three-seeded Thunderbirds with a 5-0 victory over New London earlier tonight. Jostling going on there. Gretzinger called with the push against Fishback. And a free kick, Ashland. Ashland looking to set something up top of the 18. They'll chip it. Nobody home. And that will go across the byline. Certainly not the most dangerous look that the Oerdackers have had tonight. They've not had many, but they've had a couple of good looks, a couple of extended pressures, one sort of extended volley off a throw into the box that eventually went wide. Cooper Radke has only needed to make two saves so far in this match for the Hodags. Caught for along the far side, Petrick. Let that one roll out of bounds, and it's a Hodag throw that way. Ashland first touch off the throw, but it goes right back to the Hodags. Hack had it taken away for a moment, but now settled back in. King will track it down near his side. That went off an Ashland chest. So he'll just let that go on a touch, throw in for the Hodags. Looking up line for Mork. Played by Ashland. Weiss steps in front of that pass to knock it away, but gathered back in by Viscossel. Near his side as they looked up line to Swanson. Out of bounds it goes, last off Leo Loesch. Swanson gets it right back off the redirect in traffic. They were looking for Ramdi Gokki. He tried to split defenders, got a piece of it, but it goes out of bounds. Another goal kick for the Hodags. Sub for Rhinelander as Schinner's returns. He'll take off Will Quinn. And Schinner's will play one of the forward spots right now for the Hodags. Deep exploratory efforts sent well wide by Norton. Radke liked his chances playing it instead of settling for the goal kick. Hodags try to play it up line. King missing Henricks, and it goes out of bounds. Throw in Ashland. Swanson trying to find Goike along the end line. Too strong. A goal kick for Rhinelander. Ashland had a man on the backside. Goike could have kept that in and squared it. Hodags play quickly off the goal kick with Xavier Adams back to the goal. Adams was the man on the backside there. That cross that pushed deep up that the Oerdackers couldn't cross. Sent to the touch now by Ashland, throwing Rhinelander on the edge of its defensive third. Ashland picks up. Ball comes free. Between the defenders, slide tackle attempt there to no avail by Weigel. Cleared out of the middle by Weiss. Hodag sent it ahead. Mork, the send went long. Schinner's will turn around. That one will be on the edge of the box. Schinner's will track it down in the corner. Sends it back to Henricks, deflects off him, back to Matthew King. Looking to send it over to Weiss. Weiss will be pulled down. A foul on Viscossel. And the Hodags will have a direct kick here from 35 yards. Be Braden Mork to take this one. Booking, one hopper. Owen Britton's there. Records his ninth save of the match. Boot that one away. ball sent long by Ashland. Radke well out of goal. We'll let that roll in a touch. Both teams to sub. William Dykstra returns for Ashland. And Will Quinn back in for the Hodags. Off the throw and far side looking for Petrick. Thought I may have heard a whistle, but they play on, and this one sent in the touch. In fact, there may have been a whistle. Nope, going to be a throw in near side. Dykstra put it in. Ball high in the air looking for Shinners. He'll head it along for Gretzinger. Far side, steered along and out of bounds. Ashland lobbying for and getting a call that it is their throw in. Petrick, far side, nifty move. Creates some space looking for Gretzinger. Hard tackle attempt on the ball played by Ashland. Trying to play it up line there are the Oradockers. Ball comes free. Gathered by Petrick. Petrick trying to chip it ahead. Quinn thought that was coming inside. Instead, Petrick was trying to push him wide. Ball went off Ashland last, throwing Rhinelander. Whiffed upon the near side by Swanson. Hodags throw it back to Weiss. Not much doing there. Weiss just kicks it off of Adams and into touch. Throwing for the Hodags. Mork trying to cut in front of Viscosso there. Sent back to Shinners. Charlie Heck, 50 yards with a little space, trying to cross it right. Petrick's on that flank. Gretzinger blocked the clearance. Ashland's got it back and sends it up line far side. 58th minute, Hodags ahead 3-0. Off the strength of goals by Charlie Heck, Braden Mork, and Mason Shinners in the opening half. Then no score here in the second. Mork far side looking for Gretzinger. Cleared aside and in the touch by Ashland. David Goitke on the far side, he cleared it away. Mork will throw in for Rhinelander. We'll throw it back to Weigel. Who's challenged? Ball comes free. A lot of hand fighting there. And now, tempers flare. Weigel. And it looked like Adams. Weigel will get booked, as will Adams. Both receive yellow cards. Assume the official explanation given for both will be unsporting behavior. Both Weigel and Adams booked after that altercation, and there will be a free kick for Ashland off all of that. Side played by the Oradockers. Picasso, 30 yards away. King will cut him off. They still jostle for it near side. Weiss will send that in the touch. Rowan Ashland. High bouncing ball. Will Quinn on the run. got by his man. Hodags with even numbers, but it's cleared away by David Goyke. Rowan Rhinelander near side. They try to put win on a run toward the corner. Sent in the touch deep on the sideline by Ashland. Rowan Rhinelander. As we near the 1 hour mark, 20 minutes separating the Hodags from a trip to the regional finals. Mork to cross it. Petrick couldn't get the second redirect. Dykstra was able to shield him. And Britton able to cover up and clear it away. Perhaps had more time than he thought he did. And gives Rhinelander a quarter. Seventh of the matchup coming here. Back post, header, will go wide. It appeared as if Mork was the one who nodded that one wide. As we come up on 18 minutes remaining. Retzinger far side to Petrick. Petrick, Mork, space closing quickly, but able to get it ahead. Shedders, back to Mork. We'll drop it back, looking for King. Quick look, nobody home. A goal kick for Ashland. Time in the favor of the Hodags now. Up three. Under 18 minutes to play. King deflected it. Loesch gets a touch. Two Ordockers collide. King had a piece of it. And now sent out of bounds by Ashland Swanson. Last the touch. Hodags will check a man in. That's Weigel returning after getting booked a few moments ago. He had replaced Trevin Rapley. Far side, Ashland looking to play it along. In the touch it goes. And another Hodag throw in. Edge of the attacking third. Here's Braden Mork. Will chip one into the box. Petrick backside. Ashland first to and able to clear it. Hankey sends it into touch. Hodags will look to throw quickly. In it comes to Mork. That one out of bounds, and I think that will be an Ashland throw. It is. Now the Ordockers will sub. And Adams, who was also sent off in that little set two, will return for Ashland. Rowan missed everybody. Loesch first to play for Rhinelander. Mork able to drop it back to Charlie Heck. Heck up the middle. Knocked away by David Goyke. Near side, Loesch. One on from behind. Able to drop it back to Matthew King. Slots ahead to Mork. Near side, Will Quinn on the flank. Quinn looking to carry. Was poked away from behind. I think that one will roll sent out, throwing Rhinelander into the box. It goes. Knocked out of bounds. Under 15 minutes remain. As the Hodags look to punch their ticket, move on to the regional final round. They were one and done of the playoffs last year. Falling to Medford on penalty kicks in the regional semifinal round. two seed this year. Rolling far side by Weiss. Touches nobody. Goal kick Ashland. Goal kick upcoming for the Ordockers here. Should this result hold, Rhinelander Lakeland Saturday night here at Mike Webster Stadium. Both results 2-0 during the regular season, split by the teams, the home side winning each fixture. Lakeland winning 2-0 September 8th up at Incredible Bank Field. Hodags returning the favor a couple of weeks ago here at Mike Webster Stadium. Quick shot, top of the 18 by Mork, sends one in on the redirect, and that goes wide. Goal kick. Lakeland with one of the most explosive offensive players in the GNC, and Yaroslav Mishishin, second of the conference in goals scored and total points. He will certainly be one who the Hodags will have a lot of attention on Saturday night should they move on. Okay, near side for Mork. Quinn, a little space, closes quickly, chips it ahead. Braden Mork. Rhinelander, as they've had a habit of doing sometimes this year. Thinking football parlance, maybe a more of a Woody Hayes, 3 yards and a cloud of dust, as opposed to a Mike Leach air raid offense. Not afraid to be stubborn, pounding the ball up the middle instead of sometimes working the flanks, and I know at times that's been to the chagrin of head coach Nathan Bates. Especially think of teams who are further down the conference table. Anago comes to mind. They would congest the box against Rhinelander. Bozenied did a lot the same in their two matches. And sometimes Rhinelander too comfortable with sending it up the middle instead of working the flanks. But they do have 3 goals to work with here. And coming up on 11 and a half minutes to defend. And a push on Ashland to Jerome Jones with an admonishment to the Ashland defense to tone things down a touch in their aggression. Kyle Weiss with a 45-yard direct kick. For Petrick, off his hip, ball is still free. Petrick in space! Shane Petrick, it trundles across the line! 4-0 Rhinelander. I think the Hodags can safely start getting ready for a regional final matchup here on Saturday night.
Fourth goal of the night for the Hodags, senior number 7, Shane Petrick.
Owen Britton, he's been strong for Ashland tonight. He got a piece of that one, but just not enough as that trundled in just barely across the goal line and just barely inside the left post. Petrick with his 16th goal of the season has the Hodags up 4-0 in the 70th minute. Ashland, their best chance of the night on the counterattack. Radke comes out to smother the advances of Xavier Adams and will quickly clear it away. Hodags, Quinn ahead. Can Gretzinger get there? No. Britton able to pick it up. Boots it away here as we come up on 10 minutes to go in this one. loose in the midfield, now gathered by Heck. Three defenders closing. Hodags will chip it along. Cleared by David Goyke.
10 minutes remaining.
King looking to shoot one through the middle. Trying to find Jenners, was steered away. Ball to the near side. Knocked out of bounds. Last touch. Rundlett. Gomez was in the vicinity for the Oradockers. Back in after getting shaken up in the first half. A couple of Ashland players have needed a moment or two to collect themselves after being standing in front of Rhinelander. Either clearance or shot attempts. Gomez was one. David Goyke the other, but both back in the game now. Gomez midfield, dispossessed by Quinn. Far side it goes to Kyle Weiss. Hodags trying to time this one. Weiss carries far corner. Now looks to square it. Falls down, we play on. Supporting that on the far side, Rhinelander. Gretzinger sends it back. Henricks. Make that Quinn back to Loesch. Working along. Give it go, Quinn. Too high. And a half minutes remaining. Norton in on the goal kick here. Gretzinger will win it for Rhinelander. Looking to make a cheeky move past the midfield there. Ashland having none of it. Picked up now by Viscoso on the near side. In the touch, last off of Ashland. And Rhinelander will have a sub here. That's senior Tate Werner, number 8, checking in. He'll replace Mason Schinners. Perhaps is starting to extend things a little bit here with this game seemingly well in hand. Along the near side, played by Ashland up line. King near side, gathered by the Oradockers, misplayed by Gomez and sits out of bounds. Rhinelander will sum in another. That is Rapley, Trevin Rapley checking in. Another senior. Still outside, 5 minutes to go in the match, so clock continues to run during these Hodag substitutions. He'll whistle. May have been an elbow in there on Rhinelander. And a foul on the Hodags. Free kick by Fischbach. Oradockers can't track it down. A goal kick for Rhinelander. Radke will take it quickly. Quinn sends it back to Loesch. Far side it goes to Fischbach. Ashland may have something on the far side with Adams. Looking to spin back into the box. Adams with the cross on goal, covered up by Radke. That's Ashland's first shot on goal this half. Third of the match. Gretzinger jostling for that one, out of bounds off of Rhinelander last. This will be Sims on the throw in for the Oradockers. Heck will send that one into the night sky and out of play. As we tick down inside of 5.5 minutes to go in this one. Gathered by the Hodags, here's Leo Loesch. Plenty of space. Kyle Weiss, can he split the defenders? Ball comes wide. Staying on that one, Petrick. Ashland will settle it and now shoot it away. Quick throw in, Hendricks. Petrick could not keep it in. Well, they play on. Rob Howe had the flag up, and I think they do have it now, the throw in to Ashland. I believe this crew does wear the earpieces, where the assistant refs can communicate with the center ref. In a case like that, where the center ref has his back to the AR, couldn't see the flag. Contact there, and now foul. A little extracurricular there. McCostle and Matthew King. Jerome Jones does not go to the pocket. And we'll play on. Just barely still in, Petrick. Hendricks, working along to Charlie Heck. In space, Wynn between defenders, has a man, Weiss, it's still alive, tried to get into Gretzinger, save made by Britton. Far side it goes and kicked into touch by Ashland. A corner upcoming. Double-digit saves now for English. That was his 10th of the match. Henricks on the corner. Headed by Heck. Near post, couldn't find Petrick. Goal kick, Ashland. Being told in that one of the other regional semifinals, Mosinee, the 5 seed, is upset Wapaka 2-1. So it looks like it'll be an all GNC regional final in D3. Rhinelander Lakeland here. Mosinee and Medford in Medford. Both games Saturday night. That means the Great Northern Conference, which had 4 of the top 5 seeds in this bracket, will have a representative in the sectional final 1 week from Saturday. It's just a matter of which of the top 4 of the GNC will represent the Hodags there. 2 minutes to go. Petrick into the box. Hard challenge by Weiss and a late foul called, it appears. He ran into Gorky there. Rhinelander's 6th foul of the match. Ashland with 9 infractions. Milo Gomez for Ashland here. Looked to set something up, nothing doing. As we're in the final 90 seconds of this one. Still trying to keep up the pressure on the attack. I'm sure they know the Lakeland New London score and be surprised if they're trying to match. Foul Rhinelander there. And a
1 minute remaining.
Out of the way, just into the box by Rhinelander. Ashland trying to set something up here near his side. McCostle trying to create some space for himself. Ball comes free. Loesch slipped. McCostle pushed it wide right. Half a minute to go. Cooper Radke in no rush. Charlie Heck will give this one the boots. And along by Braden Mork. And Hammond sent in the touch. 10, the countdown 9, begins. 8, a 7, convincing victory 6, for the Hodags tonight. 5, 4, and we'll see you here 3, in 48 hours 2, 1. In an all GNC regional final. Hodags 4, Hordockers 0. It's gone final.
A hard fought battle tonight with the Hodags coming out on top.
And Rhineland Falls, Lakeland here Saturday night.
To both teams on an excellent season. The Hodags will move on and play here Saturday night versus Lakeland at 7 p.m. Be here. Bring a friend. Bring two.
Again.
Bring more. Let's cheer on the Hodags on Saturday night.
Channel. Shane Petrick getting the lone goal of the second half of the Hodags that coming in the 70th minute. Again, recapping goals by Charlie Heck in the 23rd minute. That assisted by Will Gretzinger. Great work by Andrew Hendricks in the 36th minute. Mason Schinners from Neil Weigel in the 37th minute. Hodags 34 shots tonight, 14 on frame. Ashman 8 shots, 3 on goal. Saturday night, 7 o'clock here at Mike Webster Stadium. The two of them.
Thank you. come and get it. Just a sec.